The light bulb went on for Presbyterian College football, which had the bright idea to sign a lights out defensive dynamo. Energized by improvisation and ingenuity, Night Dog senior Khalil Denis and his family still wired this happy occasion despite a town-wide blackout. Meaning this night still had his time to shine.
Before we begin, let's just give a round of applause to the parents for hosting.
While his faithful supporters illuminated his yesteryear with memories collected, reaching today and tomorrow glow.
The wins and losses will take care of itself, right? But every so often you get a special kid. You get somebody that's coachable, you get somebody that's tough, and Khalil exemplified that, and I'm talking about at age five. I mean, I remember going through drills and him hitting other players. I had to remind him, that's your teammate, you know? Players would always complain and moan. At that age, Khalil would just go do it. And he was never afraid, he never backed down. I'm so proud and privileged to have been a part of your journey. The advice that I want to tell you, Khalil, is one thing that I said, and I don't know if you remember, but never take the path of least resistance. Right. In football, if that lineman is pushing you to the right, well, you know that play is going to the left, right? If he's pushing to the left, you know that play is going to the right. You're taking the path of least resistance if you go that way. Continue to go against the grain. Continue to keep fighting and doing everything that you're doing. They're gonna say, when you get to school, they're gonna say, Khalil, come on out and come do this and come do that. But you know you got work to do. Don't take the path of least resistance. Keep fighting, keep doing what got you here today. God bless you, man. I love you. Keep up the good work, and I'm telling you, man, I'm proud of you. I'm proud of you.
That's a special player. His IQ, football IQ, is amazing. From my perspective, you're gonna be an amazing football player next level, and we'll miss you, man. You're here, Night Dog. So it's been a pleasure to watch you grow. Always fun guy to be around. Always got something funny to say. But just to kind of reiterate what Coach Crosby said, it's been a pleasure to coach you. It's been a brotherhood, a friendship that has grown. And you know, I'm definitely proud of you. I'm excited to see you. Like I told you before, next step is Saturdays. After that, you take that next step. So I know you're going to ball out, done it. Presbyterian, I'm proud of you.
It's a blessing just to work with such fine, outstanding youth. And Khalil exemplifies all the great qualities that we express at Knightdale High School. Character, commitment, all right, and leadership. I've gotten the pleasure to watch him, you know, for 4 years, three of those years with the varsity football team, and he has put together some wonderful stats. I was reviewing his stats today. He has 286 tackles in his four-year career. 185 of them are for loss, or excuse me, 185 of them are solo tackles. 45 of them are for losses. He has three fumbles caused, two for recovery, and one interception in his four-year career.
Two safeties.
Yes, and two safeties. Sorry. Coach Timmons, he apologizes that he cannot be here tonight, but he did send me something to read, and this is a tribute to Khalil and his 4 years here at Knightdale. He said, Khalil was part of the reason for the transformation of Knightdale High School football. He's a leader on and off the field. He pushed his teammates to match his strength in the weight room. He always set the tone for the defense with his hard-hitting style. He made teaching and coaching at Knightdale easier and a joy. He will be greatly missed.
I'm Michaela, Khalil's sister. At first, I didn't want to speak because I felt myself being a little emotional. But I just wanted to say that I'm really proud of my brother. you know, with me being 7 years older than him, I feel like basketball kind of brought me a little closer to him. 6 and a half, 7, same difference. But just like, you know, waking up early on Saturday mornings when he was younger, like being in the cold, you know, sacrificing my weekends and stuff. I want him to know that I really, really love him and I'm really proud of him. And, you know, I knew he was going to go far all along. So I'm just looking forward to the future.
And 4 years old, probably 5 years old. You asked him what he wanted to do. I wanted to play football, you know, and I've seen over the years just him grow, not only as a football player, I mean, obviously, you know, signing these papers, but just as a young man. And that's really, I know what I'm most proud of. I know that's what his parents are most proud of as well, that he is, you know, not only an outstanding football player, but an outstanding young man that, you know, represents his family in the right way. Represents his community in the right way. And, you know, that's just, to me, that's the best part about it. And the football, that's also great, but, you know, that's to me, that's a result of, you know, the young man that you become. So I just want to say, man, on behalf of me and my family, that we are so proud of you. And, you know, a little weather wasn't going to stop me from getting here. So proud of you, all the things that you've done to this point. But really, more so, even excited for all the things you're going to do in the future, man. So love you, and we'll keep praying for you, keep supporting you, making that trip down to South Carolina. And, you know, this is only the beginning. So look forward to see where the rest of the journey goes for you.
Oh, one of Khalil's sisters, too. I'm going to try not to cry.
You already sound
like... Girl, these hormones. Okay. So, seeing Khalil grow up, I always knew that football is what he wanted to do. Please, I don't want to cry, y'all. But I mean, when I was like 13 or 14, Khalil was like 6 or 7. And Aunt Timmy was like, did he help play with Khalil with football? Y'all, he tackled me in the house. And I was like, wait, hold on. I was like, dang, this hurts. So I was like, if he's doing this to me and I'm a teenager, he's a problem on the field. I already know that going to college, of course, we will be there to cheer you on right there, whenever, however, but we will be there, especially with your godmama and Jackie, too. We'll always be there, but I just want to say that you'll always have our support. We're always in our prayers, and I already know that you'll be, or you're destined for greatness, and you will go far in life.
Thank you.
You will do.
This little boy in my house running around tackling the furniture. And I kept yelling at him and kept putting on punishment, but for some reason, tackling that blue couch. We had a blue couch. He kept hitting the pillows, tackling the blue couch. We put him in soccer. That didn't work. He still had too much energy. So his mom was like, first of all, I had a boy for football. I didn't have a son for soccer. I specifically say, God, I want a son for football. So we took, and you know, and he was getting in trouble in school because he was rough with the other kids. And for some reason, as soon as Coach White put that pad on him, and I told them, look, you are not going to get in trouble. Hit him as hard as you can. Are you sure? Because last time I did that, you told me, you know. And I said, no, on the field, you can hit him as hard as you want. Nothing's going to happen. And we heard the first clap. We knew. Yeah. That's why he was tackling the furniture. And then he had a football in his hand. He slept with it, walked with it. Everything he did was football. You remember those days?
Yeah.
That's when we knew, you know, this is his calling. This is something God has called him to do. But Khalil, I just want to tell you, you know, always practice like you're trying to get somewhere. And when you get there, I want you to play like you are an MVP.
That's right.
I always tell, you know, even in high school, I told them, don't play like a high school player. Play like a college player. Play where you want to go. That way, when you get there, it's not a strange place. You're already familiar with that place. Always play where you're trying to go. Prepare yourself for the future. Don't play for the present. Play for your future. And I'm very proud of you as a father. You get on my nerves. God knows you do. But I am very proud of you for the young man that you are becoming. This decision, it was a decision that was made through prayer and great, strong conversations. But at the end, it was conversation that was built on wisdom. You know, and we didn't go in with feelings. We went in with facts, and we went in with prayer. And I'm very happy, and I'm excited, and I can't wait to see what you do at PC. And I pray to God they let you keep 2-2, because I can't come up with another slogan for another number.
First of all, I just want to thank each and every one of you for being here tonight. It means a lot. It takes a village to do what has been done and will continue to be done through Khalil and for Khalil. So we just want to say thank you, every one of you, the friends, the family, the church family. We just say thank you for being here in this weather. Thank God for the generator. We'll be in the dark right about now. But just want to just share that this brief story, it was not, destined. The devil didn't have he had a plan for Khalil not to be at this point. At 3 years old, the doctors at Duke came in the hospital and said almost that he would never walk again, but that he would walk with a limp. He would never play any sports. Like my husband stated, I had a boy to play football, you know? So the woman of God that I am, a faith believer, I told them, don't come back to the room with no negative report, because I choose to believe the report of the Lord. And so I told them, we're not receiving that. He will play football. He will not walk with a limp. So every time you see me in the stands hollering, go Khalil, go Sonny. Why? Because he wasn't supposed to be doing if it was up to the doctors.
The doctors are all doctors,
and that's my God. And he said that Khalil will go on, and he's not just playing anywhere. You go online and read about Presbyterian. God has granted us favor and granted Khalil favor to go to this prestigious school. It's a D1 school, and he's going there. You have to have good grades to get in the school. He just ain't sliding in. And we had favor with the coaches. They wanted my son so bad. The other coaches at Charleston Southern and the various other schools. And like my husband said, we had to pray. This was a decision, because we want him to be there for, you know, as long as God would desire for him to be there. But we wanted the right fit for my child. I want him not just to be playing football, but I want him to be in the classrooms, you know, getting his degree when he leaves this school. It's just not about football.
That's right.
You know, I'm going to be there on Saturday. But I want to be there that Saturday when he crossed the stage with a degree in his hand. So, again, Khalil, I am proud of both of my children, but I'm tonight, it's about Khalil, Nightingale, all the coaches that have imparted. Coach White, I thank you from day one, imparting into him, showing him the correct way to hit. Coach Valio as athletic director, Crosby, Coach Timmons, who's not here, and all the other coaches that have imparted into him, and Coach Hardy. It's been a journey, you know, from 5 years old until now, and we're going to keep journeying on until we get to the Giants. Yeah.
That came here, I know the weather and all that. I just want to say thank you for everybody that came, friends, family. But this was a tough ride. I remember my freshman year, man, and y'all probably know, had some ups. I mean, it had some downs too. So I don't probably think I'll ever get this far, but couldn't have good people around me that changed my ways, made me change friends, had good people around me. I just want to thank Nightdale, I want to thank the coaching staff for making me have an opportunity to play at a Division I level. I want to thank my parents. I know we argue probably every day, but deep down I do love y'all for real. I love my family, I love my friends for real, for real. I really want to thank everybody. I'm not trying to cry on camera. I mean, I don't cry. Man, I love everybody. Just thank you for this opportunity. I'm like grateful. Thank God that I'm here, blessed. And I love everybody, man. Thank you, for real, for real. I love y'all.
We just want to thank you for your 4 years of hard work at Nightdale High School. It's been a pleasure. And we know that in the future, you're going to represent Nightdale High School to the best. And from all of us at Nightdale High School, you are always welcome back to the school. We want you to come back. We want you to share with our future athletes what it takes okay, to make it in the next level. And we are going to support you the best we can in your journey at Presbyterian. Three, two, one.
Yes, sir.
After Real Deal Khalil made it official, he shared more of his selfie. As someone always aiming the full of focus spotlight on Khalil Denis the Menace, it's my turn to thank him for being a gridiron beacon and never ever phoning in a powerhouse performance. This is Don Fuller, East Wake Television.